All right, guys, welcome back to another episode of Off-Axis Builds. It's been a while since I've done a catch-up tutorial type video on what's going on with Night Owl. There's a lot that I've done with it. I just spoke with good old Mike, and he brought up a good point that I should put out a video of just all the little stuff I've been doing. Just to kind of get you guys up to date. I know you can check out my old videos, but, you know, to be honest, I know you guys don't have time to go through thousands of hours of videos. So let's go ahead and do a walk around of Night Owl. This project has been about a 3-year project. It's been a fun little build. It started out as a Baja bug. It started out as blue Baja bug. And it just kind of grew from there to what you see now. I had the fiberglass fenders. I had the fiberglass hood that all came with it. So, and the bug eyed front end. And I just love the look of it, but I wanted to tweak it a little bit, and obviously I tweaked it a little bit more than I was planning on. Originally, I thought this project was going to be done within 6 months to a year, but just started getting into it, and I just couldn't stop. I mean, it was just one thing after another I wanted to customize. So let's go over some of the customization that I've done on this thing. And we'll start from, hopefully you can see the front. It's in the garage, it's almost nighttime now, so I won't be able to get you a good view of that, but I'll show you some pictures so you can get a good idea what's going on up there. But anyways, guys, remember to like, comment, subscribe, and hit that little bell for upcoming notifications, and check out my new merch. Got that link down below for that. I also have some hats. So check that stuff out. Any help helps me out to keep this thing going. So remember, guys, lost where I was going. Remember, guys, to like, comment, subscribe, and we'll get going on this walkthrough. All right, guys. All right, guys, so I hope the lighting isn't too bad. One of the projects I've been working on is putting this water reservoir in for the windshield wipers. That guy, I tucked it up there nicely right behind the front nose. Obviously, that's not where the nose is gonna go. It's gonna go back up here. I had it welded onto a brace down here, but it just didn't clear the front nose, so I had to move it up. So that was one of the projects that I've been working on. Video to come shortly on that guy. But another part of it, coming on down here, I changed this thing out to a rack and pinion. Don't know why I did it, to be honest. I just wanted to be different. I like the look of everything being centered. And, you know, it actually quickens the steering by a full half turn, 3/4 turn. So it's definitely quick steering, which is kind of cool. I can't wait to actually drive it. I think it's going to be something like a go-kart at this point. So moving on to this trunk section. I actually made this thing. Let's see if I can get some light on there. All right. So I actually made these two little pockets to fit my gas tanks. Okay, those are 2 5-gallon gas tanks that I had welded at the top with a bung at the top, and then also 2 drain ports down at this end, so I can tie them together and have it go to one pump. I have 2 sensors on it. I'm probably only going to use one. I'm going to see if I can tie them both in. I don't know if I'll be able to. I don't know if the sensor will allow that. Not a big deal. I like things symmetrical. Obviously, you can see with the tanks and some of the other stuff I've done. So I might just coil that cord up inside the one side and just have it run here, or I might even just have it run down and tie it in so I can use it at a later date. So my plan with this was to originally paint it, but I think I'm gonna stick with this brushed aluminum look. I'm just gonna clean up all the
markings on it and brush those pieces to match the tank, smooth it up so it's not so rough, and then just go ahead and use it as is. I think it looks good the way it is. So that will mount here and here. Obviously the fill tank will, or the filler nozzle will be up top. So this was a 68. I used to have the gas door there. You can't see it now because of all the carpet work that I've done, so I completely hid that. I've always liked the idea of having the gas filler under the hood. My 67 had that and I just loved it. I never really liked the doors on the side. So there's that. Moving on. I obviously, you see the shock towers are a little different. I'm running air shocks on here. Let's get a little light underneath there. I'm running air shocks up underneath there, okay? I can get the numbers on those. I think they're 756s, I believe. And I want to say they can go down to 7 inches and up to, I want to say, 14 inch up. So it's got almost 7 inches of travel. Really cool. In the beam, I took out the springs inside so I can actually run those air shocks. So there's a through rod on both the top and bottom. And then obviously you see that there's a sway bar. I did that just to kind of help stability, help it get a little better turn stability. And then coming up underneath here, I have 2.5 inch drop spindles and disc brakes. I actually have disc brakes all the way around, so I'm pretty excited about that. Woo! So I'm pretty excited about that. Those brakes are gonna definitely stop this vehicle. Also, one other modification I had to do to the shock there, I had to bring back the shock mount. So originally it was right here. I had to bring it back about 3 inches. Now the reason for that is to get some clearance right there. So that was not touching this guy, okay? Some people have notched it out and that works just fine. I didn't want to notch it out, so I moved it back. So I made that whole bracket, welded it back in, and it is what you see there. I've also welded on a full cover plate to kind of give it a little more beefiness look. Wrapped it up underneath. Didn't have to do that, I just did that to finish it off. So underneath here, I'm gonna have basically all my air controls. I'll have my fuel pump, I'll have my fuel filter. I'm not gonna run the filter all the way back. So I'll have all that underneath here. I am actually running a Holley fuel pump. I believe it maxes out at 7 PSI, which is perfect for what my carburetor is gonna hold. I'll go into that a little bit more in detail a little bit later. In fact, you can see there's my rack and pinion. I pulled it out to do some work up here. You'll actually see a video coming up as well of my son and I working on cleaning this beam so I can paint it. So we got that. Moving in. I don't know if you noticed those things. I have one on each side. Okay. Those are actually going to be electric heaters. Okay. And those things are going to be plumbed into these two holes that I have there. Originally this dash had 3. Originally these things are twice as long. So there's 3, about 6 inches long. I filled the middle one in. I wanted a smooth dash. Just love the look of that smooth dash. And then in one of my other videos, I don't have it out. Actually, wait, I do. I'm working on electrical. So that is part of the dash. But I'll put a picture up on how the whole dash looks. I know it's in pieces right now. And the reason for that is I'm changing my switches out. And I'll go through that in a minute. From blue to red. I just wanted to go with the red theme because obviously I have red. No blue on this car. So moving on, that will mount there. It'll come down with a push to start. It'll have all my lighting and start switches and all that up there. One of my other videos, I don't have these out right now. They're actually floorboards, okay? And these floorboards, I built them to raise my foot up to be able to control the new Wilwood pedal assembly that I installed, okay? I know a lot of the stuff I'm explaining is not in the car right now because obviously you can see I'm doing the body work, so I had to take it out to do all that. But the nice thing about that floor panel, I can actually run my electrical up underneath, hide it all, and go up underneath. So all stock has electrical that runs across that channel right there. But I didn't want that because I'm not putting carpet up over that. Most people will run carpet over that to hide that. That is gonna be smoothed out and painted. I just wanted that look, okay? Up underneath, moving on to these corner pieces, I actually have those speaker guards that are supposed to go in there. Not supposed to, but I got some plastic speaker guards with, I believe, 4-inch speakers in there. So that'll mount there, cover a lot of that stuff. And again, guys, I will post some pictures on the stuff that I missed. Hopefully I get pictures of everything, but we'll see. So moving on to the paint job, guys. This was a custom garage paint job. I still need to paint the front, obviously, you can see that. But it's a garage paint job. I used rattle can or spray cans, whatever you want to call it. Basically, I made templates and overlapped them, painted them, put on the detail what you see there. So nice little detail. This is Army olive green, I believe it is, with a matte finish over it. Okay, this car did come with some Nerf bars. Okay, originally those bolted on. I just didn't like the look of that whole section being open, so I actually got a piece of Unistrut, cut it, bent it to match the body, and then I welded these Nerf bars onto it, and then welded the Nerf bars onto the floor pan. I bolted right there just because there was already a hole there, and I figured I just used the bolt hole, and I didn't want to weld onto the body. I like the look. It looks like it's removable, but it is not. Not a big deal because I am not taking this car off road, so I don't have to really worry about those things getting trashed by trees and rocks. It's just for looks. Obviously, you can step on it. Most Nerf bars, you cannot step on it. So, you know, added feature to those. I will be keeping the doors stock. I'm not putting suicide doors on this, but I will paint the match. You can see them on the other side there. I will paint the match. I do have tinted windows for those doors, and I do have single pane glass for those. So I took out the pillar there and the double windows. So I took out that front little window, and it's a solid window now. Cool thing about this car, I am gonna have electric windows. So I'm gonna be wiring in a retrofit kit, which is gonna be really cool, with a couple switches in the center console there. And obviously my center console is out. See, a lot of this stuff I have up on the shelf. There's a center console, there's my floorboards. I just gotta get them back into the car, but obviously I need to paint, so they're not going back in right now. So this whole theme of the car, it's a Volksrad, guys. I'm going with American theme. Obviously you can see the sticker on the window there, and let's see if we can get up top. This is the hood. You can see that. I'm too short to get up there. I just put the hood on top of the car for now. So that's what it looks like. It's got a nice little painted American flag, torn American flag on it. I'll post a better picture of that. If you guys are following me on Facebook, you've probably seen a lot of these details, or Instagram. And I'll, my link's down below for Facebook and Instagram if you want to check out the photos of this car as well. Looking down underneath there, you see that little symbol there? Those are Atom Works. Great company. Those are drop spring plates, okay? Now, I don't know if the drop spring plates can actually be flipped around, used as raised spring plates. You'll have to talk to the company on that. I don't think so, but you'll have to talk to them on that. Anyways, so they have a little notch in them. don't know if you can see that down there. And it raises up the rear end by 2.5 inches, okay? So I did that, and then I also re-indexed my rear end to make it to where it's a full, I think, 3.5 inch drop in the rear. So I have 3.5 in the back that's static, and I have 2.5 in the front. Obviously, the air shock right there will let me drop the front to the ground. Well, technically to the ground. It's about 0.5 inch off the ground. And the reason why I planned that out is because if I lose an air shock, I don't want to lose steering. I'd want to be able to control the car to the side of the road. So let's crawl under the car. This part I'm really excited about. I just finished it up. I don't know if you can see that. That's a skid plate. Look at that. I am actually gonna put some red underglow in that skid plate, but that skid plate is protecting my four lines that I'm running. I needed to replace the fuel line and the brake line, and I'm adding a hydraulic clutch, and I added an air line just in case I want to run air to the back of the car. So that's protecting all of that. So there's four lines under there. I had to do something to protect it, and I didn't want to chop up the tunnel and try to get four lines in there. I probably could have done the gas and brake no problem, but the other two, I didn't think it was gonna work out. So I thought it'd be easier just to go below, which it actually was a lot easier. Okay. Inside, I just finished the headliner. This stuff is just Home Depot carpet. It's lightweight carpeting. I did a two-tone, you see, obviously. And that center black section actually comes down from the roof 0.5 inch from the gray. So I gave it a little detail. I don't know if you can see that. Get a little closer. You might be able to see that on camera. I don't know. Coming inside, I took out the light. I cleaned that up, welded that up, and then also bonded over it. I got to do some touch-up paint up there because the glue ate at the paint when I was doing the headliner. Not a big deal. I deleted the rearview mirror mount. The notch is still there, but all the screws are gone. I am going to be putting an electric camera rearview mirror. It's 13-inch wide screen. It looks just like a rearview camera. And I can put that link down below too. It'd be nice because coming on back, I'll show you where it hooks up. There's a camera that goes right underneath here. I have the mount right there. And it's just gonna basically be a rear view camera. I won't need to have a rear view mirror. So I can mount that anywhere I want. Originally I was gonna go in the dash, but I decided to go with that type of radio because just the constraints that I had. Okay, so it's gonna be mounted on the bottom of my window so I can see it easily. I don't have to look up top. Okay, little more detail on this dash. That is a GPS speedometer. Okay, the rest of it's not GPS, obviously. I have fuel, speedometer, RPM, and temp. So, you know, the main gauges you need, there's the push button start, and then obviously USB plugins. If you notice, I'm putting some custom seat mounts because I have some custom seats going in here. This whole interior is custom. I have the center console, I'll have a armrest that I'm building here. Where I put it right now, I think it's back of all this stuff. I actually have a tire back here that I mounted. I wanted to kind of go with the Baja look, but I also wanted to have you know, the sporty race car type look, so I kind of mixing the two. Moving in here, that rear window was never oval. This was a 68. They didn't have ovals in 68. I made a custom ring and a Lexon window to go in there. I found one that has a slight tint to it. Can't really tell in this video, but there's a slight tint to it. These side mirror windows have a slight tint to it. They don't match, but they're close enough. I might put a tinting on that back window at some point. We'll see how I feel. Coming down here, I have 8-inch speakers. Up top, I'll have 4-inch speakers. Let's go ahead and strip some of the stuff out and show you. All right, guys, got that rear end cleared out. So that is what it's gonna look like. I have 8-inch holes for 8-inch speakers that'll be hooked up to an amp underneath here. I'll open that up and show you. I have 2 holes right here that have not cut out. That's for a 4-inch speaker, one on each side, okay? Underneath here, I got a nice little lock system here. Let's see if I can. All right, so under here, I got a nice little lock in here. It's welded onto there. Put carpet underneath. There's my air lines, brake lines, hydraulic lines, gas lines, all that. Right there on that plate, we'll be mounting my amplifier for the speakers. I still got to decide if I'm going to run all 4 speakers in the back to that amp or just the 2 8-inch. Lock it back down. Obviously, I put some detail on these rear quarter panels to kind of match what's on the outside. So that was kind of fun little detail. Here's the detail to hold this back rim down. The guys that put the tire on screwed up my rim, so I will have to air them down, repaint them. Sucks. Really makes me mad. The guys put, I don't know why they did this, they put the weights on the outside of the rim. I asked for them not to do that, and they still did. I rather would have had them put glue on weights on the inside of the rim, or fine if they want to snap these weights on the inside of the rim. I'm okay with that. It's just the outside. I didn't want them to scratch it all up. So I will be doing some touch-up paint on all of the rims. You can see a little notch there. Yeah, so another scratch there. So yeah, and then also these are Chevy 5 lugs. I have an adapter to go from the 4 lug pattern to the Chevy 5 lugs. Part of the reason why I wanted to go to the Chevy 5 lugs because there's more rims available out there with the Chevy 5 lugs. So moving on to some of the other parts I built, I have, these are going to be drink holders. I gotta figure out where to mount them. I have a few spots that I'm thinking about mounting them. So you'll see that in a later video. This is the front bumper, complete custom bumper. I just wanted to put something up there to make it look like there's a bumper up there. Obviously steering shaft. These are gonna go on my wing. They won't do anything, they're just for looks, because that wing is gonna be permanently, actually I guess they are gonna kind of work, because they're, this part's gonna mount to the beam, so I need a third support to hold them in place. So they will work. It's not just for looks. So it's kind of cool. They'll be, you know, mounted somewhere like this, off an angle in the front. Let's see if I can get a good view there. There we go. So there'll be 2, one on each side. And that is the front spoiler that I'm gonna be putting on. You've seen that in another video. I'll be putting that guy on. Also, this is a custom shift knob that I made. Screws right into my shift knob or shifter that I have. Another note on that shifter, I shortened it by 3 inches. So I originally had an empty shifter. I took out about 3 inches right in there, 2.5, somewhere in there, lowered all this stuff down, and then put it back in there with the wire and all that, so it still works. It's a short shifter. So it's impy short shifter with a shorter throw because I shortened it up by 3 inches. Let's see, what else have I got here, guys? I put adjustable springs in the rear. And then I also put a limit strap because this is a swing axle. Swing axles are notorious for tucking underneath on turns. So that's in the air, and they are not tucking. Look at that. They're straight up and down in the air. It's got it on jacks right now, guys. Pretty happy with that. Otherwise, you'd be seeing them drop considerably down. Moving on back to the engine. Originally 1600. It is now 1641 with a 32-34 pick progressive carb. I had to make a linkage to actually have this operate properly. See that? Because before it was just going to here. It was never getting that last full throttle. So I had to make this linkage. Now, let's see here. This is an Impy carburetor. If you were to go with the original, what is it? Weber's, I believe they are. They have the whole linkage that you need. I had to make that linkage. In fact, I had to buy that guy to help support it. And yeah, did I buy that guy? No, I made this guy. It's been a while since I've touched this engine. So I made that guy to help support it. If you look over here, I got electronic flamethrower, high capacity distributor. I also have electronic, did I say distributor? I meant coil. But I also have a high, I have electronic flamethrower distributor. It is vacuum assist. So I tied that right into my manifold there. Let's see, what else do I have going on here? Not much other than the electronic side. I got rid of the points. I got rid of the original coil. By putting that coil in there, I was able to open up my spark plugs to 0.040. I've heard you can go up to 0.045, where stock is actually, I believe, 3.0. I believe that, if I could be wrong on that. I think it's 3.0 though. I put on some bolt-on valve covers. Impy, nice bolt-on. Painted those to kind of go with the theme of the car. Brushed the front off, so gave it just a little bit of chrome. I don't know if you noticed in this whole car, there isn't much chrome. I'm not a fan of chrome. I used to love it, but I'm just, lately I've just been more of a fan of blacking things out. So you got that. I have the 1.25 rockers in here. I didn't want to jump up to the 1.4 rockers. I thought it was just gonna be too much for the 1641. So I got the 1.25s. With chromoly push rods. I went with chromoly just because I didn't want them to expand and contract so quick. I just wanted them to be more stable. Some say it's a good idea, some say it's not. We'll find out. So when I set my valves, I set them at zero tolerance. Some of you guys may say, wow, that's pretty tight. Well, here's the thing. Chromoly doesn't expand and contract the same way aluminum does. From what I've been reading, if I were to set it with the stock gap, they would be knocking like crazy once the car warms up. And when I started up on a cold morning, you can't even tell that it's that tight. It only sounds tight for maybe, I don't know, 2 minutes or less. Not even that. Moving on down, you see that little orange canister? I did put an oil filter on. So it's a nice little feature. I painted my sprockets. My sprockets. Well, I guess it is sprockets for my belt. Pulleys. My bad. I went with a K&N air filter. This kit did come with a cheapo fabric air filter, so I went with K&N. Came out. I just love the look of the K&Ns. Notice the firewall. That firewall I've actually insulated and brought it off of the back wall 1 inch. The reason why I did that is to kind of get a little bit more soundproofing in the car. Inside, I've actually put a lot of soundproofing. So, not that I don't like the way the Volkswagen sound, I just want to be able to talk inside. Remounted my license plate up here, welded it to the two hood brackets. Since I won't be using those, I didn't need them. Let's see what else. Oh, the exhaust cans. Those are motorcycle exhaust cans. I believe they're 9 inches long. I don't know how long that red anodized is going to hold up. We'll see. I may have to paint them. I made my own exhaust Y, I guess you could say. Welded all that together. These were the original pipes that came on it. It had a big can that came off and then came off to the side. In fact, I believe it was made by Impey as well. I took all that off. I didn't like the look of that. Went with this. Obviously, you guys seen most of the vehicle. I like things symmetrical. Tail lights. I had to put some tail lights in here because I'm not running fenders. So I went with these. Those are motorcycle tail lights. In order for me to control them properly, I'm going to have a trailer controller. What that does is it allows me to put power to the wires for both brake and turn, okay? So, otherwise these would just be running and brake or running and turn. Now I can have them running, brake, and turn with just those three wires right there. Yep. Guess how I got those things in there? Look at that, I had to reach my hand up in there. What a pain that was. I scratched my hand all up getting those things in. But, part of building, guys. What's that little red bar right there? Okay, so, I saw Duckman Cycles put on a kafer bar, I believe that's what they're called, on his oval. I loved it. I wanted, to put one in here. I was looking around for one. I found one. I'm like, you know what? I can build it. So, I built it. Look at that. And painted it obviously red to match the rest. It goes from shock tower to shock tower. I don't know if it's as sturdy as the one you would buy from Kafer. But I think it's gonna work. Oh, and I also have another sway bar back here. I ran 3/4 both front and rear. Maybe overkill, but hey, you know what? I'm okay with it. Custom bumper. I have an air dam that I'm putting underneath here to direct the air flow across the bottom of the engine. I had a sump pump underneath here, but originally I had the car so low that I just felt the sump pump was going to get torn off. And I've heard issues with having them on as far as leaking issues. So you know what? I just removed it. And I'm going to put, like I said, a skid plate down there. Let's see, what else have I done to this car? Oh, yeah, this pushrod tube. Those are the ones that you can change out without removing everything. I don't know if I'm totally thrilled with it. I've only started this car maybe a dozen times just to tune it. I already have some dripping out of one and two. One of those, I can't remember which one. It drips right at that spring right there and that little rubber gasket. I don't know. This side, it doesn't look like it's dripping. The other side, I've had one. I've tried to reset them. We'll see. If it's total complete failure, I don't know. Maybe I'll just get some new pushrod tubes or RTV, that joint, I don't know. You really don't want RTV. You want them to be able to expand with the engine. And that is why they put the aluminum ones there, because once they're stuck in the two holes, they do move with the engine slightly, so they keep their seal. You can see I have rear spoiler. I don't know if that does anything. It's more for looks, guys. And here's a little close-up of my custom paint job. Got a little black spray in there just to kind of give it an old look, make it look like a piece of metal is glued down. I can't show you this right now because my hood's up, but you can kind of get an idea what's up there. That's a roof rack that I built. Okay. It's all aluminum. Bolted it right through the top of the car. Probably shouldn't have, but hey, you know what? I'm okay with it. I've caulked it. There's rubber gaskets up there, so I'm good. Let's see. What else do I have? Oh, a third brake light. Also a light for my license plate. I think that's kind of where it's at right now, guys. You can see I have disc brakes in the rear. I'm debating whether or not, obviously these doors are going to match the color, but I'm debating whether or not I should put that star on the doors or not. I have the decals to do that. I think I will, and I think it's going to match my hood, be, you know, that red and black tone. So I think I may just do that. The door handles will be blacked out. I also have a screw up here for my rear view, or not rear view, my side mirrors. I'm no longer going to have the side ones down here. It's going to be up the top here, hanging off to the side. So, I think that's it, guys. I think that's it. I mean, I could go on for another 20 minutes or so just talking about this, that, and other thing, but I think that's it. All right, guys, so I almost forgot to show you the best part of this car. This part, I just love it. This is the Wilwood setup. I have Wilwood throttle. I had to make a linkage for the throttle cable, not a big deal. I have a Wilwood brake, front and rear, and then a Wilwood clutch, hydraulic clutch, look at that. Also, I don't know if you noticed, those are not straight. Okay, so Wilwood makes them straight. But that was way too close for me to get my foot in here for the gas. And hopefully I can get it off to get to the brake. Just too tight. So I actually cut, notch, bent it over, put them back. I think I moved them over almost a half an inch. Yeah, roughly about a half an inch on both of them to match. So I'm pretty happy with it. Now you can actually heel toe if you want to. You can actually use the gas, quickly use the brake if you want to. So part of the reason why I raised the floor up, look at that height. That's almost a foot from there to there. So I raised my floor up 2 inches roughly. That gets my heel up higher, so I'm not so low on any of these pedals. Be able to control them a lot better. So I think the floorboard actually is somewhere in here. So I'll be able to get my foot on there a lot easier. Won't have to keep my foot floating in the air. So I think that's one of the best parts of this whole car. I just love that. Loved how I had to do that. Let's see if I can get some light in here. You can see that if it's too dark. I had to notch that out to push my pedals forward enough. Otherwise, they'd be way out, because you see, that's actually where the pedals sit. But I need a spot for all the hydraulic assembly. So I actually had to notch that out, put a box in there, and then push it all back. They're almost in the stock location. I think they're about maybe an inch closer to the driver than stock. So I'm pretty happy with that. Also, I'm going to be putting a cover plate in here to hide a lot of that stuff. gonna have the same dimpled die-in circles like that rear deck lid piece, or heat guard, I should say. Let's see here. Sorry if I'm making you guys sick. It's gonna have a similar look to those.
All right, guys. Thanks for joining me on another episode of Off-Axis Builds. I know it was a long video. I had a lot to go over, a lot of custom stuff I built on this car, and it was time to go over this. Thanks for good old Mike mentioning that. So I you know, took his advice. I'm bringing you guys a full walk around of the car. There might have been some small details I left out. We'll get that in another video. But you guys got the gist of it. I'm pretty happy with how this car's turning out. I'm excited to actually start driving. I'm hopefully going to be able to drive it around July. We'll see. I said that last year, and here it is. We're in March now of 2021. So, you know, it's the way it goes. But again, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for all my followers keeping up with my channel. And thanks to all the new subscribers. Really do appreciate that, guys. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and hit that little bell for upcoming notifications, guys. Remember, guys, it's always built, not bought. We'll see you on the next one, guys. Thanks.